Good evening. We're so glad you joined us tonight. We pray that you have the Lord Jesus on your heart and your mind tonight and all day. Jesus wants to walk with us, talk to us, hear our heartbeat, let us know that He loves us, He cares for us. We just need to draw near. Let's draw near right now to our Heavenly Father. Jesus told us to go and pray to the Father like this. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Father, we just praise you and thank you for your love for us. We thank you for our salvation through your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus, for coming and dying on that cross, our perfect sacrifice. You took our sin in your body on that tree and paid the price for us that we might go free. Thank you for opening up our eyes to the truth, our need for a Savior. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I pray for each and every one of my brothers and sisters in you that are listening tonight, that they would be blessed immeasurably. They would just overflow with joy because you are our joy, Jesus. You are our source of joy. And we come to you tonight and ask you to fill us with joy and peace and love. Help us to love you, Father, and love one another with all of our hearts. We praise you and bless you, Father, in Jesus' precious name. And everybody said, Amen.
Amen, Pastor Nikki. Oh, it's so good to be with y'all today.
Yes.
Just got back from Jacksonville, and we both had our vaccine shot.
Moderna.
Got to go back in February to get the second shot. But as we went to Baptist South, and they had lines and lines of people filling out all the paperwork. Nikki and I made our appointment online last night. I thought about how, what a mess this world's in. And people are there to get this shot, and I was too, because I don't want the COVID. Nobody that had it wanted it. But I know that my Redeemer liveth. And I know this one thing, that Jesus is coming soon.
Amen.
Nikki and I will both be going on 77 this year, but I believe I'll see the return of Jesus in my lifetime here on earth. Folks, we need to get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. We're in trying times. I looked at all the people waiting in the lines.
So sad.
And I wondered how many of them, if they died today, would go to heaven. And you know, when you start looking at people and thinking about their salvation and eternity, it comes upon you. And I said, God, Nikki and I will do whatever we can to help someone. Help someone make it into heaven, to show them the way.
Amen.
And that's why we're here today.
Yes.
We're here today to tell you that there's hope in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That Jesus is our rock.
Amen.
That Jesus is the one that can get us where we need to go.
Amen.
And folks, this life is short. But I'll say this. The time that we have, we can do something for the kingdom of God.
Yes.
We can be a part. And that's why we're here with the good news. To let you know. Don't let the devil creep into your life. Don't let him creep into your mind. Don't let him get you to say and do things that you shouldn't. Don't let the devil get into the way that you handle bad situations. Let Jesus Christ bring you a peace that's not of this world.
Yes.
And so I'm going to get Pastor Nikki to come and sing a song. Then I'm going to bring you a message today. I believe I got a good one. I believe I got a good one for you today. I know it's going to be a good one for me. And so, Pastor Nikki, you come and give us just a little old testimony, and I'll get the music for you.
Okay.
The soundtrack you made not too long ago.
All right. This song was written by Dottie Rambo, a woman who was in pain every day of her life. I don't know how long, but she went to be with the Lord, and she left us a lot of wonderful music. And this one, "Where do I go when there's no one else to turn to? Who do I talk to? Jesus is waiting for us to come to Him. He'll listen, and He's got an answer. Thank you, Lord." Where do I go when there's no one else to turn to? Who do I talk to when no one wants to listen? Who do I lean on when there's no foundation stable? I go to the rock. I know that He's able. I go to the rock. I go to the rock of my salvation. Go to the stone that the builders rejected. Run to the mountain dance. The mountain stands by me. The earth all around me is sinking sand. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. When I need a shelter, when I need a friend, I go to the rock. Where do I hide till the storms have all passed over? Where do I run to when the wind sorrow threaten? Is there a refuge in the time of tribulation? All of my soul needs consolation. I go to the rock.
Amen.
Yes, I do.
Amen.
I go to the rock of my salvation. Go to the stone that the builders rejected. Run to the mountain man. The mountain comes to me, stands by me. The earth all around me is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand. When I need a shelter, when I need a friend, I go to the rock. I go to the rock. My salvation, go to the stone that the builders rejected. Run to the mountain man, the mountain stands by me. The earth all around me is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand. When I need a shelter, when I need to the right. Amen. And I've learned to remain in that rock every minute of the day, not just run to him when there's trouble, but to talk to him, love on him, say, Jesus, I love you. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. Thank you for leading and directing my life every minute of the day. Thank you for the breath that you give me to breathe. Thank you for the understanding that you're always there. You're here with me all the time. Jesus in me, my hope of glory. I hope you've learned that. Jesus wants to stick close to you like closer than a brother, the word says. Well, I'm reading today from John 10, verses 7 through 11. Then Jesus said unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy.
Yes.
Jesus said, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. Amen.
Oh, amen.
I discovered that 43 years ago. He is my shepherd.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Nikki.
Yes. How wonderful.
As I said before, today we drove up to Jacksonville to Baptist South Hospital, where they had made a place to give out the vaccine. And we had made our appointment time online last night. And something happened to me as I seen all of the people at Baptist South. Thank God for our healthcare workers. Thank God for our doctors, our first responders. You know, we need to keep them continually in prayer. Now, I went to the Lord about getting this vaccine shot because there's so much on the media that you don't know what to believe.
Amen.
But you know, I went to the Lord and the Lord showed me that we have a part in this walk in life with our God. That God has given us free will. Free will to make choices. Now you may say, well, I've made some bad ones. Well, I have too. But you know, when you seek God, the power of the Spirit, the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, will lead you. The Bible says that the footsteps of a righteous person is ordered by the Lord.
Amen.
And so, I feel real comfortable in taking the vaccination shot. And so, we went today. Had the first, we got to go back in February to have the second one. Folks, you ought to have seen the lines of people. There was like five or six lines of people. And Baptist South Hospital, the healthcare people were so efficient. And the lines moved real well. But while I was in the lines, I was looking at all the people, and I was wondering how many of them are so fearful of dying. And if they're fearful of dying, then I wonder where they would go.
Yes.
Now, only God knows who's going to go to heaven and who's going to go to hell ahead of time. But I was thinking, as I was there to get the vaccination because my whole purpose and Pastor Nikki's whole purpose is to do what we can. Eat right, sleep right, do right, and do whatever's necessary to be healthy enough to do ministry. That's our whole purpose.
Amen.
Pastor Nikki, you know, as we pray and continually in prayer, that our heart is to please God.
Amen.
And, you know, I was wanting to go fishing today, but we went to Jacksonville and got the COVID vaccination and come back, and we were just so tired that she laid on the couch. I got my chair, and we took a nap and woke up, and it was almost time to do the good news. But, you know, there are a lot of things more important than fishing. But don't get me wrong. I love to fish. I love to eat them. But people are living, and as I saw today, people are letting the devil influence them to live in fear, hatred, bitterness. And as Pastor Nikki read the scriptures, Jesus told them this parable that I am the door. Are you in a place that you are miserable and depressed? Anxiety, depression, you name it. Are you in a place that you don't want to be, that it's ruining your life, it's taking away the quality of your life, then you need to go through the door. Because when you go through Jesus, He said, I am the door. When you go through that door, you're going to find a whole nother kind of life.
Amen.
You're going to find a life of victory. You're going to find a life of being an overcomer.
Yes.
Jesus wants His people to be a light in a dark world.
Amen.
Jesus wants us. Jesus wants you and me as a born-again child of God to be a testimony of His grace and His power.
Amen.
And today I was just thinking, the lady that gave me the shot, I was telling her how blessed I was and how good God has been to me.
Yes.
And to witness wherever we go.
Yes.
Now we don't have to just walk around saying I'm so holy and so heavenly minded, you're no earthly good. But Jesus wants us to come through the door, come through Him, and that we might be used.
Yes.
I've told you over and over, these are trying times. I don't have to tell you that. But I want to tell you, we can overcome through Jesus Christ, the door.
Amen.
Jesus said, I am the door, and by me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. Well, sheep love a good pasture where they can feed good.
Amen.
And when they feed good, they're so peaceful. They are so happy. And when they feed good, when they eat good, and when they're peaceful and they're happy, that wool grows real fast. And then they can be a benefit to the shepherd that is watching over them. And I think about that. I don't mind being called a sheep, and I want to grow wool to where the Lord God can shear me and use that to help other people.
Amen.
Jesus said, and this is what really stood out to me, the thief cometh not before to steal. He wants to steal your joy. He wants to steal your relationship with your friends. He wants to steal your relationship with your family. He wants to steal your worship when you go to church. He is cometh not to do one thing, but to kill, steal, and to destroy.
That's right.
But Jesus said, I got some good news for you. I am come that they may have life. Glory to God. And that they might have it more abundantly.
Yes.
You might say, how can anybody have a good life with all the trouble that's going on around? I can tell you what Jesus says. He came to give us life. Listen. Jesus Christ and our Father and the Holy Ghost knows how to take care of His people.
Amen.
We are the sheep of His pasture. We can go through the door. And when things get too hot, when the enemy comes and surrounds us to rob, steal, and destroy, we can go through the door. We can go through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we can shut Him out of our life.
Amen. I like that.
Amen. Amen. Listen, our life is short here on earth, and it's too short to have miserable days, empty days, depressed days, days of anxiety. Listen. God, we know the scriptures. God's not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind.
Yes.
Listen to me today. Listen, child of God. We've got to get back to the Word and get in the Word and learn. Jesus said in the 11th verse of the 10th chapter of John, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. And that's exactly what Jesus did. He gave his life so that we may have life. In the 10th verse, I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly.
Amen.
Well, if you've got to have money to be happy, you'll never be happy. If you've got to have this or have that to be happy, you'll never be happy. But I want to tell you, when you start walking with Jesus and you start to experience the abundant life, and immediately people think about riches. Listen, the rich life is knowing Jesus Christ as our good shepherd.
Amen.
The riches of this life will burn up and be gone. But the riches in Jesus Christ will last for an eternity.
For an eternity.
And so I am calling upon God's people today. I'm calling up on you if you are truly, truly a born-again Christian. It is time for us to stand up and to be counted and to show people what the world needs is Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, yes. Pastor Nikki and I took the COVID vaccine shot. But it was because we're not afraid of dying. We want to live more for Jesus here on this earth. That's our whole purpose, beloved, is to bring honor and glory to the good shepherd, the one that gave his life for the sheep, for the one that came to this earth and went up Calvary's hill, mm-hmm. carrying that cross, and was nailed to that cross so that you and I could be forgiven of our sins. Praise God. I don't know about you, but I can tell you I feel so good that Jesus forgave me of my sins. And it's a daily cleansing. I ask Him every day, Lord, forgive me where I've failed You. Forgive me if I've sinned against You. Forgive me, Lord, because I want to stay in good standing with God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I don't know how much time. I was thinking about it today. Pastor Nikki and I will be 77 My. Never thought I would live that long. But you know what? There's something in me, and that's the Spirit of God that says that Pastor Nikki and I have got some more time left to serve Him. There are souls to rescue. There are souls to save. I'm telling you folks today that so many of God's people are starving to death spiritually. They go to church empty and they leave empty. And God wants to fill us daily, continually, each and every day. Fill us to overflowing. Listen, how are you going to help somebody else if you ain't got nothing in you?
That's right.
And you may say, well, I got saved 25 years ago, and I know I'm going to heaven. Is that enough for you? It's not enough for me. I want a daily feeling, a renewing.
Yes.
I want to always get back to my first love.
Yes.
I want to be able to tell people about Jesus if I'm at the filling station, the restaurant, wherever I am. If I'm at Walmart, it doesn't matter. If God gives me an opening, I'm going to say or do something. You know what? There's nothing wrong with saying to a complete stranger, how you doing today? You know God thinks you're special. And you know what? If God thinks you're special, you are special.
Amen.
And God's not forgot about none of you.
Amen.
And so, in closing today, I want to give the invitation to the lost person.
Amen.
I want to give the invitation to the person that has not been born again.
Amen.
God loves you.
Amen.
There's nothing God wouldn't do to help bring you into a relationship with Jesus. Our Father loves you today. And I'm calling up on you, sinner. Better get right quick. There's not much time left. He's calling you now. Would you come? Would you come? And Christian, I am calling out to you today. What kind of testimony do you have to a lost and dying world? Is God not greater than this COVID? Is God not greater than you needing a job? Is God not greater than you needing food on the table? Single parents, listen. God sees your struggle. He wants you to come and let Him help you. Because He loves you and wants you to have the abundant life. Once again, I'm not talking about a pocket full of money. It's having peace in your heart. Going to bed, able to sleep. You don't need the drugs. You don't need the alcohol. You don't need sexual perversion. You don't need nothing but Jesus.
Amen.
And He's calling on you today. We're going to close. And Pastor Nikki's going to play and sing some of this song. My Father watches over me. I love you and God bless your heart. If you received a blessing, let me know. Just say, I got a blessing. Thank you so much for that. I want to say hello to my family up in West Virginia. Oh, I love y'all so much. And my family here in Florida.
Can you sing this?
I'll try.
Okay.
I'll try one verse, okay? I trust in God wherever I may be, up on the land or on the rolling sea, for come what may.
Love you.